Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video released today on the 19th of October. We have our second look at a new Battle Pass season vehicle. This time it is a ground vehicle. Previously it was the HMS Gay Archer, which we looked at in the previous episode, of course. But now we get a new Italian mobile artillery truck, basically. I don't know if this thing is artillery or if it's supposed to be like an artillery anti-air piece, but I haven't read the dev blog yet, so we'll just have to wait and see. Obviously in the game it will be a tank destroyer, but I mean historically speaking. So this is the Italian Breda 90/53. It's a self-propelled gun on a wheeled Breda 52 truck, and it will soon arrive to War Thunder as one of the main prizes in the upcoming battle pass season Tropical Storm. So it's the Breda 90/53. It's a premium self-propelled vehicle for Italy of rank 3. Features a powerful and deadly 90mm cannon. However, it lacks protection and has mediocre mobility, something that you'd pretty much expect from this series of vehicles. This isn't the first of this type that we've had in the game. There are a few vehicles in the game that are trucks and or half-tracks that are like this. You've got the 8.8cm half-track that the Germans get, of course the Jag truck that the Russians get, which are these like mobile artillery trucks, though those ones are historically anti-air vehicles. I'm curious to know what this one was historically. We've got a few camouflages here for it. Obviously the I'm not sure which one of these is going to be a collectible camouflage from the battle pass, since I don't know what the Italian camouflages in the game are, but we can see a few of them here. The nice look at it. It's definitely a bit of a wonky looking one. I love that when the door, well, I say doors, but when the back of the truck is down, it creates just a perfectly circular platform, which is really derpy looking, but it is what it is. Here's some history on the vehicle. This might actually tell us if what it was supposed to be. It began development as a self-propelled anti-aircraft vehicle, but it looks like it was later changed so that it could provide direct fire at enemy ground vehicles. So let's take a closer look at the vehicle itself. One of the main prizes of the upcoming new Battle Pass season Tropical Storm will be this cool wheeled tank destroyer, the Breda 90/53, which was Italy's way of mounting a heavy anti-aircraft gun onto a wheeled chassis. Exposed to the elements of featuring thin armor, the Breda 90/53 can still pack a deadly punch with its very capable 90mm self-propelled gun. The 90/53's standout feature is that it is built around the truck itself, which is already in the game through the 90/52 M41M. However, the gun. The M41M can only carry 8 rounds of ammunition of fire. I remember that vehicle very well. That's been in the game for a while. I have not played the Italian tech tree extensively aside from when it released, so that time will come at some point in the future, and it would be nice to have vehicles like this, because these are fun vehicles to drive when you're not being shot at. However, as it says that vehicle can only carry 8 rounds, this one will be able to carry more. It doesn't specify how many, though. Its devastating cannon is powerful enough to deal with almost any enemy at rank 3 with its great one-shot potential. Interestingly, this vehicle's full name literally combines its two most basic elements, the cannon name first, and then the truck name. SU, or SU, is just the Italian word for on, so the name quite quaintly ends up effectively being Gun on Truck. Full Italian name being, well, yeah, there it is for you to read. And here we've got, well, that's just the main picture of it with the tan paint. Placing a 90mm gun on an army truck clearly comes with downsides in terms of protection, but this does mean enough space as a rotating platform to fire from multiple angles. The crew of this vehicle, as well as the large ammunition supply, are also placed on the back of the space. All in all, Italy now gets their own version of the popular German 8.8cm Flak 37, but with premium bonuses, which I had mentioned previously. Did you know Italy got the idea of mounting 90mm anti-aircraft guns on tracked and wheeled vehicles from the successful experience of Germans utilizing 88mm Flak 18 guns on tracked vehicles against French heavy tanks? As we mentioned, a truck platform quite obviously comes with some downsides, namely its large silhouette and general lack of protection for the crew. As a result of this, the 9053 is easy pickings for enemies on the ground as well as in the air. In addition to this, the 52 Army truck does not feature great driving characteristics, having only an average speed. And here we've got some more screenshots of the vehicle with varying camouflages. Again, I have no idea which one is the collectible camouflage, if it's even being shown here. I would imagine it would be something more like this, though. And here we, of course, have pro tips by Tom, Oxy, War Thunder Community Manager. Positioning really is key with this one. It's not a vehicle that can react quickly to new threats from different locations, so you don't want to be caught out on the move. Aim to keep your distance from enemies and stay defensive. The 90mm, oh my god. Stand defensive? No, you can't do that in a ground warfare simulation. That makes no sense. That's just filthy camping. The 90mm doesn't need to be up close to be effective, and at range, your poor survivability and low mobility aren't as detrimental. When you're engaging, try to position yourself side on to what you're fighting. This breaks up your silhouette and makes it harder for an enemy to disable your ability to move and shoot in one shot. Unless they're using high explosive, always take high explosive. Okay. The new wheeled self-propelled vehicle will, of course, be available with the next season pass, which is starting on the 25th of October. This one's definitely interesting looking. I think the gun would be a lot of fun to use, and I've used these types of vehicles on both the German and Russian tech tree, and they can be very effective. Interestingly, though, this isn't a complaint necessarily, but this isn't the only vehicle in the game that has the, I don't know what these are actually called, but if we open up the picture here, you can see these things here. These are meant to be, because the truck itself was not made, unless this truck was made, but I highly doubt it. This truck was not made to, you know, house a massive artillery piece on it. So to offset that, they put these types of things on these vehicles so that they can deploy to basically absorb the shock. They're essentially braces so that the recoil of the gun doesn't flip the fucking truck over. Multiple vehicles in War Thunder have these. And in fact, you can even see that these have what look like shock absorbers right there, just fully visible. But you can't deploy them, so I don't know. It'd be cool to have that detail. Of course, in this game, they don't actually replicate recoil very well. A lot of the weight things with vehicles in this game aren't displayed correctly to real physics, like the KV-2, for example. But obviously, that's just to maintain a smooth gameplay experience. Though I do still think it would be cool if we could deploy these for a less recoil type of situation, because there are some vehicles in the game where their gun produces so much recoil that your gun flips all over the place after you fire for a few seconds. But yeah, you can see these types of things on a few other artillery vehicles in the game. They're just not usable. But they're there on the model. Anyways, that's going to bring this dev blog to an end. So as for other stuff they've announced for the next Battle Pass and for the next major update, which are both being announced, the next Battle Pass has also shown off this, which is the HMS Gay Archer, which is a new torpedo boat for Great Britain, another reward, the naval reward for the Battle Pass. For ground forces, they have shown off the Vickers Mark 11, which is basically a prototype wheeled fighting vehicle for their light tank line, essentially, which is coming in the next major update. And also in the next major update are two new premium rank 5 battleships, the HMS Iron Duke for Great Britain and the Imperial Japanese Navy Yamashiro for Japan. But until next time, I'll see you guys around in whatever the hell it is I'm doing.